standing at sea level, your head is at an altitude of 2 meters, and the horizon appears to be about 3 miles or 5 kilometers away. We're able to see more distant objects if they're taller, like buildings or mountains, or when we're higher up in the air. If you get to an altitude of 20 meters, the horizon stretches out to about 11 kilometers. But we can see objects in space which are even more distant with the naked eye. The moon is 385,000 kilometers away, and the sun is a whopping 150 million kilometers. Visible all the way down here on Earth, the most distant object in the solar system that we can see without a telescope is Saturn at 1.5 billion kilometers away. In the very darkest conditions, the human eye can see stars at magnitude 6.5 or greater, which works out to about 9,000 individual stars. Sirius, the brightest star in the sky, is 8.6 light years. The most distant bright star, Deneb, is about 1,500 light years away from Earth. If someone was looking back at us right now, they could be seeing the election of the 52nd Pope, St. Hermitus, in the 6th century. There are even a couple of really bright stars in the 8,000 light-year range that we might just barely be able to see without a telescope. If a star detonates, we can see it much further away. The famous 1006 supernova was the brightest in history, recorded in China, Japan, and the Middle East. It was a total of 7,200 light-years away and was visible in the daytime. There's even large structures we can see. Outside the galaxy, the Large Magellanic Cloud is 160,000 light-years, and the Small Magellanic Cloud is almost 200,000 light-years away. Unfortunately for us up in the north, these are only visible from the southern hemisphere. The most distant thing we can see with our bare eyeballs is Andromeda at 2.6 million light-years, which in dark skies looks like a fuzzy blob. Now, if we cheat and get a little help, say with binoculars, you can see magnitude 10 fainter stars and galaxies at more than 10 million light years away. With a telescope, you can see much, much further. A regular 8-inch telescope would let you see the brightest quasars more than 2 billion light years away. Using gravitational lensing, the amazing Hubble Space Telescope can see galaxies incredibly far out, where the light had left them just hundreds of millions of years after the Big Bang. If you could see in other wavelengths, you could see different distances. Fortunately for our precious radiation-sensitive organs, gamma and X-rays are blocked by our atmosphere. But if you could see in that spectrum, you could see objects exploding billions of light years away. And if you could see in the radio spectrum, you'd be able to see the cosmic microwave background radiation surrounding us in all directions and marking the edge of the observable universe. Wouldn't that be cool? Well, maybe we can, just a little. Turn on your television, and some of the static on the screen is this very background radiation, the afterglow of the Big Bang. So what do you think? What would you like to see in the universe if you could get a close-up view? Tell us in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Never miss an episode by clicking subscribe. The Guide to Space is made possible by members of our Patreon community. And we'd like to thank Macy Rudinsky and James Thompson, and the many others who contribute to help us bring great space and astronomy content every month. If you'd like to join our community and get advanced access to episodes, as well as extra and behind the scenes content, click here and check out our page on Patreon. And we'd like to thank Macy? All right, let's try it. If a star detonates, we can see it much further away. The famous 1,000 millions of years after the Big Bang. That's wrong.